Yeah. So last time we spoke, you were Lance, and now you are Lucy. So let's, I guess, start from the beginning. When did you have an inkling that you were born the wrong gender?
Well, I always knew that just when you're a kid in the 80s, there's no words for that. Like, it's not an option, you know, or at least where I was, it wasn't an option in Texas where I was at the time. But like my only friend, my only like playmate friend when I was a little kid was this nice girl named Joanna. And I would totally like wear her clothes and stuff. And I was like, and then I kind of like, people found out and they were like, you know, like parents sometimes do, like, don't do that. So I was like, oh shit, okay, I shouldn't do that. And then as I grew up, my mom works kind of fashion industry adjacent, so she dressed me well, you know what I mean? And I looked good as a dude. I was very socially awkward, but I had, that's a whole nother story, but it's just easier to be a dude. I mean, not to be too cringy about it, but when you're like a pretty good looking cis white male in a middle class family, like life is kind of, it's easier. It's privileged is what it is. It's privileged. So I was like, whoa, fuck this up. You know what I mean? I was scared. I was not willing to. And have the bravery that like the two kids in my high school had to come out as gay, you know what I mean? Or right. anything like that. And also I didn't know what trans was yet. So I didn't know what I was. I was like,
right.
Yeah. So fast forward to I'm in my 20s, I start meeting actual trans people. And initially I'm like, oh God, that looks really difficult. I hope I don't have to do that. But I think a lot of cis people, the first time you meet a trans person, would be like, whoa, what's it like? Oh my God. Like, I have questions, but I don't want to make you uncomfortable. Like, you know, that's more what I get than, oh shit, how hard is it? Like, what do I have to do? You know, like I knew then. I was just hoping I wouldn't have to. Like, I could be Lance Hart that wears fishnets and pantyhose and does like gender bendy stuff. And it was getting celebrated and I was winning awards and I was making like money hand over fist just doing that. The whole time I'm like, why are no other like muscly cis dudes putting fishnets on? Because I'm killing it over here. It's the easiest thing. They're like $8. I just throw them on and then do regular porn, but in fishnets. And people are like freaking out like, oh my God. So anyway, I was just doing that and I was like, okay, well, this is cool. And then, I just worked, you know, I built Perv Out and da da da, empire building mode ensued. And so I was just go, 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 go. Like, I'm sure you've experienced when you're an entrepreneur and just building a thing, it's kind of all you do, you know, like that. And of course, fell in love with my wife. So, and then that was like the main focus in my life. And then still trying to build the empire. There wasn't much time for like feeling what's going on the inside. You know what I mean? Other than like, I'm in love. This is amazing. But not like, what am I, like if I detach from everything, what am I? You know, I don't have time for that shit. So pandemic happens. I'm making more money than ever because I own so much content and people are just buying it all, you know, because everyone's locked up at home. Business is growing, everything's growing. And I worked myself, I did what the entrepreneur's dream is, I think for everyone, is I worked myself out of my own business. Like I outsourced, literally, it began as like I can outsource being on set. Like I just paid directors to do this for me. Cool, I don't even have to go on set now, what? And then I hired like an admin person. And then I was like, okay, that person does all the emails and the da-da-da-da. Okay, cool. And it was like an exercise. And then it ended up being like an obsession. Like, how little can I do? And I got it down to like 2 to 3 days a month of like focus on the porn network I ran. And I didn't really have to do anything else. And then it got down to like a couple hours a month of like, I had to run payroll and that was it. And I was like, I made it. Yay. Retired, 42 years old, married, never having kids. We're done. You know what I mean? Like fucking cool. Maybe I'll work and get a rental property or some bullshit. Like, I'm done with life. This is so cool. And I really enjoyed that for like 2 hours. And then I like it just was overwhelming. I was like, I didn't have anything distracting me. So, and at the same time, Charlotte was just killing it at life at a whole new level. Like, learning how to play the harp while doing new career shit she'd never done before and all this kind of, so she was busy, like busier than she'd ever been. So I had a lot more time just kind of alone. And yeah, like literally 2 hours into it, it was like this, not a voice in my head. It wasn't that, but it was, and it wasn't even a feeling, it was just an awareness of like, okay, time to transition to female. That was it. Wow. Just like, shit. You know, what really happened was that was happening. And then I was like, well, I'll shave my legs. I was like home. I was in a hotel alone. And I was like, shave my legs. Let's see. I've never done that. It's so weird that I've never shaved my legs with all the queer shit I've done in my life, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, oh, this would be fun. I don't know, whatever. Shave my legs. And then I look down and I'm like, that's me. Those are my legs. Like for the first time in my life. Like that's smooth lady legs. And I was like, fuck. I was kind of pissed. I was like, fuck, this is going to be hard. I really was hoping to just enjoy 30 or 40 years of fucking off. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Like total financial freedom. Just do whatever the fuck you want. Yeah. And then now I got this thing ahead of me. I got to transition. Fuck. But good news is, I'm again, like, it's cringy to like celebrate privilege, but also I worked my ass off to get the resources and the connections. So I don't, it's a weird thing to, basically, I've had it easy with this transition because I know people who know the best doctors, and I know, and I have friends with, I'm friends with lots of beautiful trans women who've done all the stuff they had to do, and I can just call them and text them and like, hey, what about this procedure? What do you think? And they're like, don't do that. Or, oh no, that's cool. Do that. Or I'm doing that right now. You know what I mean? Like that.
Mm-hmm.
That's such a leg up. And then my wife being like super gay helps a ton. Cause when I told her, hey, I shaved my legs, I'm kind of thinking about transitioning. And at first I was like, I don't want to do the hormone thing. I'm like, that seems weird, but maybe I'll just dress more femme. And she was like, really cool. Oh, that's hot. You know, like it wasn't like a lot of married couples. It's like, she's reading books like to try to be supportive, and she's like, everything in this book is like some lady freaking out because she found panties in her husband's drawer and like having a meltdown. And I'm like, if I found panties, you have panties in your drawer, you always have, but like if I found something more feminine, I'd be excited, you know what I mean? Like it's kind of,
yeah,
we got really lucky in that sense.
Yeah,
actually the day before we got married, we're hanging out with a bunch of friends, and she was like, it's so weird to me that I'm marrying a man. Like, I've always dated women, but I love you. I mean, this is great, but weird, right? And I was like, huh, you know? And so here we are. Just kind of funny, like how life does sometimes, you know?
God, that is.
But yeah, then just I kicked it off with I'm really lucky. I knew, my friend Colby Jansen's a performer. Before Colby was a gay porn superstar, everything superstar porn person, Colby was a scientist, like, you know, like schooled up lab, did nerdy science shit. And someone that Colby worked with happens to now be arguably like the top endocrinologist in the world when it comes to transitioning people. And it's like the go-to, like the person, if there's a Netflix special about someone transitioning, they probably went to this guy. You know what I mean? It's like he's the guy. And so that was a huge leg up, like starting off with hormones done right. And there's a lot of misinformation out there, and the medicine is just not caught up. You know, I mean, it's better than ever, but if you go to a doctor, if you just go to your health insurance, if you have health insurance and you're like, transition or whatever, search, just start your search there, you're probably going to get fucked up. Like you're going to get into a road that doesn't work, or it's bad side effects, or totally wrong information about like how things work. And so I've been very fortunate in that sense, but I've also had to work my butt off to like learn.
Hey guys, if you want to support my show, then you should think about joining my Patreon. At my Patreon, I offer all kinds of amazing perks in exchange for your financial support. From live streams of my interviews as they are happening, to bonus Q&As, behind the scenes photos and videos of my shoots, plus cool merch like stickers, mugs, and hoodies, we have you covered. So go to patreon.com/HollyRandallUnfiltered. And while you're at it, make sure that you click that subscribe button so you don't miss a single one of my new updates.